Everybody's familiar with that basic diagram. Everybody familiar? Excellent. Okay. As we step back and take a look at the coaching process, more at a 10,000 meter look, step back a little bit and ask the question, what is coaching fundamentally? I mean, we can get into the model right away, and a lot of people, in fact, Debbie asked me yesterday, she said, where did this model come from? And to be honest with you, it was quite an accident. About 25 years ago, myself and my partner was asked to put together a performance management system, much like yours. We did a lot of training on performance reviews, how to write objectives, and quite by accident, we used the word coaching as the tool or the mechanism to really keep everything together so that when people get to the end of the year and they have their performance reviews, no one is surprised. We said, that's the key. But managers kept coming back to us 25 years ago and saying, what is coaching exactly? Exactly how do I do it? What are the actions and the behaviors? And that's where it all started. What is coaching? Let me pick out my five words. You've touched on some of them, I think, perhaps. I have asked thousands of managers, define for me what you think coaching means. And depending on the culture, and in some cultures, quite honestly, the word coaching is a little hard to define. The root meaning of coaching, I think, is basically to transfer, to carry, to transport. That's the root meaning of coaching. But when I talk to managers, I can boil it all down. I've heard a lot of good words, vision, inspire, mentor, enable. I like these five words. Number one, I heard this first, development. And that's pretty important at Pfizer, developing people. I think we have to be good at doing that, sharing our skills, sharing our expertise with our representatives if we're going to be successful out in the field. Another key word that I like is relationships. I think you have to be good at building comfortable relationships with your representatives, because I think the litmus test of a good coach is if your coachees, if your representatives will come to you. Because we discovered early on, when you're coaching 80% of the time, it's a big number, 80% of the time, the person you're coaching, that representative, if you're out on a field visit, 80% of the time, they already know where they need help. 80% of the time. So again, I think if we can build a relationship that's comfortable, where we drive out fear, where we can get that representative to raise their hand and say, I need a little help with my closing skills, or I'm having trouble overcoming objections, or I need to learn product knowledge a little bit better, or I need to understand these Pfizer values a little bit better, I think that would be the ideal situation. So we're not always seeking them out. They're coming to us for help. So building relationships. Development is a key word. Another key word that I like is direction. I think as district managers, as regional managers, which most of you are, we have to let those folks know what's expected, where we're headed with the business, what's going to be happening, and how they can contribute. I think that's critical to clarify expectations and direction. So relationships, direction, development. The fourth word I'd like to use is a tougher word. It's accountability. I think we have a stewardship as leaders in this organization to give people constructive, honest, helpful feedback. They need to know how they're doing, where they're going, and if they're contributing to the overall mission of your district and your region. So accountability is an important area. The last word I would pick is results. Results. All coaches that I talk to, they want to win, they want to succeed.